Well, what happened at Goldsmiths, the Islamic Society said that they wanted my talk cancelled because I would violate their safe space.
Yes.
And it was hilarious and absurd because, you know, this is a society that has invited people to speak that call for the death penalty of apostates and blasphemers. And I was merely going there at the invitation of the Atheist, Secular and Humanist Society to defend the right to apostasy and blasphemy, and not to incite death against anyone. But when it wasn't cancelled, they then came and tried to disrupt the talk. But what I wanted to say is that the fact that they felt they could disrupt my talk was because a few months earlier, Warwick University Student Union had barred me from speaking there because they said that my presence there would be inflammatory and that I would incite hatred against Muslims. And again, you know, this idea that if you criticize religion or the religious right, that it's the same as placing harm and violence on people is so absurd because actually we're fighting that hate.
Sure.
And the incitement of hatred against us. It's the other way around. But, you know, the world is so topsy-turvy. So again, you know, at Goldsmiths, as you mentioned, when I was harassed by the Islamic Society, and it was more than harassment, you know, one of the ISOC members made a bomb sound.
Oh, yes.
Another one put his hand to his head to one of our members to say, it's like a death threat sign.
Sure.
And you can't see him do it, but you can see the person he did it to. They're standing by the door in the video. And one of them is a Libyan ex-Muslim woman who was actually abducted by Islamists in Libya for 3 days. She thought she was going to be killed. And all you see in the video is her putting her hand in her face and crying because it traumatized her so much.
Sure.
And she never came back to any of our events.
Sure.
And neither did the other guy that they threatened. So, you know, it was a very threatening atmosphere. And the video was available. And what was interesting is the video, it was only videotaped because the student union didn't trust what I was going to say. And they wanted evidence against me. Mm-hmm. And that's, they insisted on it being videotaped, you know. And once this happened and we put it on YouTube, they contacted me 5 times, not to apologize at the way I was treated, but to demand that the video be taken down.
Huh.
You know, and I thought, my goodness. And then I heard there were statements by the Feminist Society and the LGBTQ plus societies. And I thought, oh, they've most probably done a statement in my favor, because even though I know that's not the world we live in.
Because you were speaking about women's rights among
I was speaking about women's rights, about gay rights, about, you know. And I saw that they had actually defended the Islamic Society. And I thought, you know, that's where it really is painful, because you just feel like you've been stabbed in the back, you know, because these are people who should be on your side. And how racist of them to think that, you know, an authentic Muslim is a Muslim that wants people like me dead, who wants Sharia courts, and that they can't even contemplate the fact that us minorities can also have social and political movements. We can demand freedom. We can demand free thought. We have class politics. You know, my goodness, we have that too. In the same way that you fought for women's suffrage, we're also fighting for the right not to be veiled and the right not to have Sharia law, you know, eradicate and completely erase us from the public space. You know, they can't begin to contemplate that. And I think, you know, it's if anything's offensive, that's offensive, you know?
Yeah, I agree.